Didn't get there. Still going to keep this hand. It's not ideal by any stretch of the imagination, but it's okay. And it does have a pyroblast, after all. And a drum. And the drum is actually pretty important here. Miss on this would be useful. Am I getting slow rolled? Welcome to Slow Roll City. This hand would be insane on the play. Turn 2 Forger, Pyroblast Delver. Oof. Brutal. That would just be almost game over. Alright, Delver missed, that's good news. Cloud of Fairies, that's unfortunate. Okay, so he has Ninja. That's fine. Alright, so I just have to hope he doesn't have Daze. If he has Daze, I basically lose. Okay, he doesn't. So now it's a question of whether I Pyroblast something right away, and I think I don't. I'd rather save it. I don't know, though. Like, I need to actually aggressively use this Forger in upcoming turns. And I don't want to be sitting back blocking a Ninja, so I'm actually just going to Pyroblast that while he's tapped out. Preordain, okay. So if he keeps open mana, I obviously am not going to be casting... Alright, so he's casting Delver, so I'll be casting my Sun Chaser. Ooh, Grudge, that's a very bad draw. Alright, so... Thought Cast... Sun Chaser. And he went bottom top on his preordain, so he's not guaranteed to hit. Yeah, Sun Chaser. Really wish I had Scale of Chisgoria here. Man, that card would be so sick. But I don't. If I did, it would be a totally different game right now. Or if I had a Flare Husk. If I had kept in Flare Husk and just been able to equip that to Sun Chaser, that would have been very good too. Okay, good. Misses. Misses are very nice for me. And he's got Preordain. We'll see if he goes top to avoid... Avoid the next miss. Oh, second preordain. Curse of Chains on Forger. Interesting. I don't have anything to cast right away with it, so... Man, that's bad. And this time he went top on his preordain, so he's gonna hit. Yeah, I think I'm better off blocking. And I'm going to wait on this Leonin Squire. Like, I could start counterattacking for two, but I think it can do more useful things in case I draw a one-mana artifact that sacks. Yep. Yeah, I mean, you want top-top on that Preordain, so it's a guaranteed hit, unless he messed up. And I'm going to wait a turn to trade, because he has a Cloud of Fairies that I can block. Yep, there's the Brainstorm. This game was kind of normal for the matchup. It's all about play and draw. Although it didn't hurt him that I drew six land and a drum. Over half my draws, I just realized. That's interesting. And he's still really good on time, even with all the time he's burning. Okay, more Delvers. And he brainstormed, so that could be a guaranteed hit. And I might not want to show him the Ancient Grudge. Yeah, since I can't win anyway. So yeah, I'm not going to show him the Ancient Grudge here. Man, seven land and a drum in that many cards. It's kind of rough. Alright, so I think I'm going to go one less Squire and one more Husk. It's nice to have a bit of attrition, a bit of card advantage against this deck, but I need to get off to better starts too. In fact, I think I'll go a third Husk. Still not a big fan of Atog in the matchup. Especially since, I really don't have a lot of stuff that I can afford to sack in the deck. A lot of times if I have a Terrarian or a Star before I play Atog, I'm sacking it to play the Atog. There's just not a lot that I can actually use with Atog in this matchup. So it's just kind of worse than all the other cards. Man, how good would Electricery have been last game? That turn that he played the two Delvers and was tapped out. He had Cloud, Delver, Delver out. If I had had Electricery that turn, game is over! If I'd had Electricery instead of Pyroblast, very, very over. Electricery instead of Drum wouldn't have worked so well, because I didn't have the Great Furnace at that point. I drew all three later. Looks like opponent is using all his sideboard time, too. I wonder how many Qs this guy's in.